Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel and Merry Christmas. Hopefully you guys are having a nice holiday if you're celebrating, and hopefully EA treats us to some nice content as well. But Merry Christmas to all you guys. Enjoy it, relax, spend some time with the fam if you can. And yeah, man, it's definitely that time of the year where we are getting some content from EA Sports, whether it's a holiday or whether it's the new year with Team of the Year. It's a big time on FIFA because also a lot of new people are going to be coming onto the game in the next couple of weeks because of Christmas, because of gifts and stuff like that. A lot of people get FIFA around Christmas time because it's either on sale or they get it as a gift. So you see a lot of new players come to the game, and that affects the market a little bit as well. We will talk about that. I want to talk about what we're expecting today on Christmas for content inside of FIFA 21 because we have some stuff added into the pack code that we had after rewards last night. So about 24 hours ago, EA dropped this code. Nothing came out on Thursday. I was kind of expecting that party bag to come out on Thursday, and there's a team of the week pack that was put into the code as well. And I think honestly we're expecting that today on Christmas because it makes sense, right? This could be EA's way of giving us a Christmas present on FIFA 21, is giving us this foot freeze party bag, and they could call it like a holiday bag or whatever it could be. I think this could be something that they drop to us today. So again, we were talking about this on stream today. There's a lot of different cards that are inside of this pack. I don't know if you guys remember the party bags from last year. We had this during Summer Heat and during Foot Birthday. It was a Foot Birthday, Future Stars, or Shapeshifters player. It was basically just an SBC that EA could get people to do that would be overpriced for the cards that you could actually get from that SBC. I remember some of these being, you know, a couple hundred thousand coins to do these packs, like 86 rated squads to do these party bag packs. And really, you didn't get a lot back from it, or the potential to get a very low level card was there. And it's not a very good value pack, I guess, is what I would say. So again, what is inside of this pack? Foot freeze cards, team of the group stages, road to the finals, rule breakers, ones to watch, and record breaker. So if we take a look at this, ones to watches, I think, are the number one thing that people are not impressed with and not happy with. Why are ones to watches included in this, right? Because if you take a look at all the different cards, right? Road to the finals, sweet. There's some decent cards in there. Foot freeze items, you could get guys like Mane, like Bernardo Silva, team of the group stage, Messi, De Bruyne, Bruno Fernandes, record breaker, Mbappe, Van Dijk, Sancho, and then for rule breakers, you have guys like Pogba, you have Kane, you have Laporte. So there's a lot of high-level players that you could get from this SBC, and there's also a lot of low-level players that you could get as well. The biggest question for me is, what is EA going to price this SBC at today? I think it's almost a guarantee that it's going to come today. I don't think we're getting new cards and packs. The only card design that is in the code is that Showdown SBC or Showdown card. The two different cards, we'll talk about that in a second. I feel like that's more SBC content that could come today as well. Since we already have the 5 foot freeze items, Dembele, St. Max, Gusens, Moreno, and Chiellini in packs, and Road to the Final set number 3, I don't think we're getting anything else in packs today or this weekend. Maybe not even until next Friday, or maybe not even until Team of the Year. I feel like we're kind of done with new cards in packs unless EA really want to surprise us. But since we have all this stuff that is in packs right now, I feel like it's kind of just, it's going to be like an SBC promotion today on Friday. It's going to be a lot of SBC content and stuff like that. Now, I would, you know, they could still run lightning rounds. I would not put it past EA to run lightning rounds this weekend still for the road to the final cards. Maybe a second weekend of lightning rounds would be crazy. But like these cards have not been hit with lightning round supply yet. St. Maximin, of course, Usman, Dembele being the most two hyped up guys. This guy's up like 100k today. He was down under 1.1 mil at rewards. He's back up to 118. I do think you will see panic selling on a lot of these cards headed into the day today on Friday, because number one, this foot freeze pack, right? And we talked about it today on stream. This is the number one thing. The party bag pack is what we're looking for today in terms of panic. So all these different types of players, foot freeze, group stage, road to the final, rule breakers, ones to watch, and record breaker, you're going to want to keep your eyes on some of these prices today if you're going to be on the game, if you're going to be trying to make some coins and watch the market. these guys will get panic sold. We saw it earlier today because the pack code was released early Thursday, right? Or like late Thursday night for me, early Thursday during the day for a lot of you guys in the UK. One card that got really low today was Van Aanholt, 177 right now. He was 164. He's actually 180,000 coins. This guy was 165,000 coins today in the panic selling. Before, see that the code was dropped about right here. He was kind of 180K, dropped down to 164 right around the content drop, and then rebounded quickly after that. I would expect to see a lot of movement like this again today because people are going to see, you know, this party bag could come out. I might pack Douglas Costa, right? I might pack this card. And if the SBC does come out, you will see panic selling this morning, right? In the morning time, but you will also see panic selling after the SBC comes out for a little bit. Now, you will see most of the panic selling on the higher rated cards. Maybe a guy like Douglas Costa or a guy like a rule breaker, Harry Kane. If there's going to be any panic selling on one of those items, the higher tier, you know, like record breaker, I just said rule breaker, Laporte, rule breaker, Kane, Pogba, some of the higher level players, or like any freeze cards, like freeze Bernardo Silva. How many people are actually going to be packing a Bernardo Silva out of that party bag SBC today? It's not very likely. A lot of people are going to be packing ones to watch cards that are very low tier. Low tier ones to watches like Foot Freeze, Golovin would be a card that you probably would see a lot of people pack from a party bag SBC. Unless EA juice it today, I really feel like you're not going to see a lot of good pack pulls. That's going to create a possibility for people panic selling the cards. They think they're going to pack and they think they're going to go down because of this SBC coming out, and you'll see a rise in those cards back up, kind of like we saw on some cards yesterday on Thursday, like that Van Aanholt card, like that Douglas Costa. I know it's just a really quick trade. I bought this at 335 and sold it at 360. Not a ton of profit, but a decent amount right there. You'll take it. You know, a lot of other panic selling today. I saw this Podence, right? A lower tier card. This was 65,000 coins and is now back up at 77, right? This Scream Verratti was at one, or Scream Freeze Verratti was at 122. I think now he's probably back to 130. I'm going to probably try to cash out on this stuff tonight before it goes even lower. But in the morning with more panic selling, but he looks like he's about 130,000 coins right now. That's a little bit of a bounce back, not too crazy. I'm like kind of breaking even there, but that's the kind of stuff that you can look for today on the market is the panic selling and then the rebound afterwards, because people are going to buy those cards back for the weekend league. Now, we talked about the market implications of that SBC enough. Let's talk about like the price of this SBC. The party bag SBC they could release today. I know it's Christmas, so there's two things here that could happen, right? It's Christmas. EA wants to be very nice. We have the good SBC guy, not the bad one, who gave us Firmino at a very overpriced range. We have the good SBC guy, and let's say they make this party bag SBC like 40,000 coins, like an 83 or an 84 rated squad. I would say that's not bad value. I don't think that's too terrible of value because, you know, it might be worth the gamble. The worst player that you're going to pack from this, right? If we take a look again at all the different types of players that could be in this, ones to watch, Osimhen is probably the worst player you could pack from this, and he's like 20,000 coins. So I would pay 40 or 50K for this SBC, even knowing that I could pack somebody who's worth 20K, knowing that I have a chance at packing somebody like a 500, 600K plus card from one of these teams, or road to the final, a record breaker, rule breaker, group stage. I would take that risk and that gamble. And that's why a lot of people love these packs, is because that gamble is there. So I would say this SBC today is probably going to be somewhere around the range of like 100,000 coins, if I'm being completely honest. I think that's too expensive, but I feel like that's where EA is going to put the price tag, around 100K or maybe plus. They might require like an 86 rated squad or something like that. I don't remember what the requirement was for the AUR SBC, but that would be an SBC that's right now about 100,000 coins, which would be something around where I guess they could price this SBC. Is he just an 85 rated squad with high chem? Is that all this is? 85 rated squad with high chem. So that could be, you know, that could be a price point where EA could put this SBC today that would be kind of expensive and, you know, not really worth it in terms of what you're probably going to pack out of it. But it's also at a point where a lot of people are willing to spend 100, 150,000 coins on an SBC because that's like in their quote unquote budget for a lot of people in this game. That's why we see a lot of SBCs kind of in that like 50 to 150, maybe closer to 200K range, is because that's decently affordable for like the majority of the population on this game could afford an SBC like that. So that's kind of where I think it might be priced, somewhere around 100K. If EA is really nice to us though, 40,000 coins, 50,000 coins, or less than that would be incredible. And we would love that. And that would honestly, that would make the market go pretty crazy for a couple hours after an SBC like that would be released. We'll have to kind of watch out for that one. One other SBC that we could see today is, I mean, we talked about this in the video yesterday as well. These Showdown SBCs were added into the code. Of course, it's like one card design, right? This is the non-upgraded version. And then this would be like the upgraded version with the added color and stuff like that. I have a hunch that these might come out today as Showdown SBCs, where you take one team versus another, kind of like the Showdown SBCs we had during Summer Heat. That could be something they released today as like a quick SBC before the Boxing Day matches on Saturday. So that's there's potential for that. Or this could be maybe cards that are in packs, but I doubt that. I really don't feel like those are going to be cards in packs. I feel like that's going to be an SBC type thing that we will maybe see today. So I don't think we're going to be getting new players in packs today. I think it's honestly just going to be SBC related. We could get more prime icons because I think these prime icons that are in the game right now expire on Saturday. But it also could be an icon day on FIFA, as we're still waiting on more icons to come out because the first set with Figo, Van der Sar, and Zanetti went away. So we still have Luis Hernandez, Varane, and Bergkamp, but we're waiting for some more icon SBCs to come out in this game. So it might be kind of a quiet day because it is Christmas, but I think that Party Bag SBC is something we can not, you know, be 100% guaranteed on, but I feel like it's coming today. Again, a Team of the Week SBC was also in the code. So maybe if you're looking for panic selling today, just be careful with Team of the Week cards. There could be more panic selling on those as well. Team of the Week SBCs are usually just an 83 rated squad and an inform if it's tradable, or just an 83 rated squad and no inform if it is untradeable. So keep an eye out for that as well today. But again, it's going to be an interesting day to see how EA takes the holiday, right? It's a promo Friday, but it's also a holiday. So we'll see what EA has decided. I'm sure they're not actually going into work. I'm sure it's just preloaded. They're going to press the button and it's going to come out. So definitely keep an eye at 6 p.m. UK today, what exactly the content is. And of course, if Footwatch tweets anything else crazy out, we'll have to kind of keep that in mind as well. Now, some quick thoughts on the content that was released yesterday. Since we talked about it on stream, but we didn't actually talk about it here. I feel like this Firmino SBC is overpriced at this stage of the game. I know a lot of people are comparing this to the Scream Firmino from last year and saying that, hey, that card last year was around this price. This is an untradeable version. It has less pace. It's got way more defense, but it has like less shooting. Like, this is kind of, yes, it's a very good looking card. Yes, you have 20 days to do it. So technically, this should be out during Team of the Year. You could craft this during Team of the Year if you really wanted this card, if you're doing a lot of upgrade SBCs. But in my opinion, I feel like this is just a bit too expensive for this card right now. I wish that they would have made this like 500K, because then a lot of people would be probably interested in it and be talking about it a lot more. But instead, it's 800,000 coins plus, and that is just a testament to what is going on with this game right now, is that EA is really just doing everything they can before Team of the Year to take coins off the market, to make people lose coins in this game so that they go out and they spend more FIFA points during that time period of Team of the Year, which is coming very soon, boys. Team of the Year is coming very soon. We're going to have some videos coming up on that, some preparation stuff about Team of the Year. It could be in like a week and a half. It could be in 2 weeks, so we'll be covering that stuff very soon as well, because a lot of people are saving packs and all of that stuff and looking forward to it. But yeah, boys, that's kind of the video for today. It's probably going to be an interesting Christmas day, probably Party Bag, maybe a Showdown SBC. We'll see what EA exactly puts out for Christmas. If they want to do anything nice, if they like I mean, imagine they give us a pack. I heard somebody say in like FIFA 15 that EA gave out mega packs on Christmas. That'd be incredible. All right, that'd be incredible if they did something like that today. I'm not expecting it. I would think that'd be crazy though if they did. But Team of the Week SBC, Party Bag SBC, maybe Icons, maybe a Showdown SBC as well. It's all about SBC fodder right now. It really is, which is always inflated because of the part of the year that we are in right now, with a lot of these squad building challenges out in the game. But if a party bag goes out, 86s are probably going to go higher, man. I'm going to be completely honest, because people are addicted to the party bag SBCs because they keep seeing guys like Mane, you know, Bernardo Silva, Messi, De Bruyne, Bruno. Those are the guys they think they're going to pack, but they're actually going to pack some ones to watch card that they really don't want. So if you're somebody who's trading with SBC fodder, keep an eye out for some fluctuations on this today, because they're probably going to be going up in price if a party bag does come. I think you will see a lot of that. And then again, general market movements, I would expect some panic selling in the morning, more panic selling if the party bag SBC is very cheap, especially on the like middle to low tier cards that might be packed a decent amount, like this Podence. This would be a card that a decent amount of people would probably pack, so there might be more panic selling after 6 p.m. for that. But pre 6 p.m., you might see more panic selling and then a quicker rebound on guys like a Mane, the more expensive cards that not as many people are going to pack, because people go to the SBC, then they go buy their cards right back because they have to play weekend league, right? And it's going to be another weekend league weekend this weekend. It's on the weekend, so we have weekend league to grind. A lot of people are playing, so that's something to keep in mind, that there should be a nice little market buyback as well. I still feel like a lot of people are, you know, they're down on coins. The market is down as a whole. I don't feel like we're going to get a huge boom on the market this weekend because people are playing untradeable. It's a holiday weekend as well, so probably less people are playing. And the motivation for a lot of the hardcore users like us on this game right now is just not super duper high in terms of like wanting to grind for weekend league rewards and stuff like that. So once we get into team of the year, the hype will again resurface with all of that stuff that comes out during team of the year. But at least right now, I still feel like we're kind of in a lull. Hopefully today we get some cool stuff and a nice little cheap Christmas present from EA Sports with the party bag SBC. But if you guys enjoyed the video, smash a thumbs up on it. Comment down below if you have any questions and subscribe to the channel if you are new. Happy Friday and Merry Christmas, boys. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. Catch you guys later. Peace out.